بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته كتاب الصيام The book pertaining to fasting And Sheikh Mansour, he said مناسبة الباب The appropriateness of this chapter is of course after the author he spoke about prayer and that which is relating to it and he spoke about zakat and the regulations pertaining to zakat Then now he speaks about the fourth pillar of Islam, which is Siyam. إِذْ هُوَ رَابِعُ أَرْكَانِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَرَتَّبَهَا الْمُؤَلِّفُ كَمَا وَرَدَتْ فِي حَدِيثِ عُمَرِ ابْنِ خَطَابٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ فِي قِصَةِ جِبْرِيلَ So, what generally happens with the ulama when they speak about the fiqh of ibadah, they use the tartib, they use the order which was found in the hadith of Umar رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ in the hadith of Jibreel, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم Jibreel taught what were the arkan, what were the pillars of Islam. So he started with the salah, and tahara is before salah, because without tahara you cannot have salah, and then it's the zakah, and then it's the fasting, and then it's the hajj. This is what Sheikh Mansour is saying. Ta'rif al-siyam, what is the definition of siyam? What is the definition of fasting? He says, Sheikh Mansour, al-siyam lughatan, siyam linguistically al-imsak, is imsak. والكف والامتناع. This all means to withhold. يقال لساكت, it's said to one who is silent, صائم. That the silent person who is withholding from speech, he is صائم. He is not speaking, he is صائم. Because he's withholding from speech. ومنه قول مريم عليها السلام. And from this is the statement of Maryam in the Quran. إني نذرت للرحمن صوما فلن أكلم اليوم إنسيا. That verily I have made a vow to Allah Azza wa Jal, the merciful, that I will be sawm, that I will be in a state of sawm. So I won't speak to anybody today. So she's withholding from speech. That means that she is sawim linguistically. Shar'an, what is the definition of siyam, of fasting, technically? Istilahan, in the sharia. It is imsak an ashya maqsusa biniyya. It is to withhold from certain things with an intention. في زمن معين in a particular period of time من شخص مخصوص and this is to be done from a specific person أو يقال or another تعريف which is given and it's a more comprehensive one in my humble opinion is التعبد لله تعالى بالإمساك عن المفطرات it is to worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى by withholding from those things which break the fast من طلوع الفجر From the rising, from the coming of Fajr, the second Fajr, ila ghurub al-shams, until the sun has set. Okay, and these ta'rif, these definitions can be found in Kishaf al-Qina and Matal al-Iqna of Imam al-Bahuti. From the evidences which show us that fasting Ramadan is obligatory, is what is found in Surah al-Baqarah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون أو you who believe كتب عليكم الصيام كتب him this word means it's been legislated for you written upon you legislated meaning it's obligatory it's wajib it's been كتب عليكم fasting as it was كتب as it was legislated upon those who came before you in the hope that you will gain taqwa, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ And in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, the hadith of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, we have the hadith, بُنِيَ الْإِسْلَامُ عَلَىٰ خَمْسِ That Islam was built upon five pillars, شَهَادَةِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Giving the testimony of faith that there is none that deserves to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah azza wa jal, وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ And that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger, final messenger, وإقام الصلاة and establishing the prayer وإيتاء الزكاة and to give the zakah وحج البيت and to make hajj to the house وصوم رمضان and to fast طيب so if Islam is built on these things it means without these foundations there is no Islam therefore it's obligatory to do these matters so fasting is proved with these evidences and many more and also ijma' also consensus of the ulama Imam al-Bahuti, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions in Rawd al-Murba' his explanation of Zakat al-Mustaqnia that fasting was made obligatory upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the second year of Hijrah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fasted. How many Ramadans did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fast? Question to yourselves. How many Ramadans did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fast? It's quite a difficult question. He fasted, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fasted 9 Ramadans. 2 of them were 30 days and the rest of them, the 7, were 29 days. And this was mentioned by Sheikh Samir Suqair in his explanation of Rawd al-Murbi'. The author, Al-Hajjawi rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, يَجِبُ صَوْمُ رَمَضَانَ بِرُؤْيَةِ هِلَالِ يَجِبُ صَوْمُ رَمَضَانَ بِرُؤْيَةِ الْهِلَالِ. It's obligatory to fast Ramadan once the hilal, once the full moon of that month has been sighted. And the ba here is لِسَبَبِيَّ. The ba بِرُؤْيَةِ is سَبَبِيَّ, meaning that that is the cause for your fasting, is the ru'ya of the hilal, is the seeing of this of the moon. طيب يجب على الناس صيام رمضان إذا وجد أحد أمرين. Mansur, Sheikh Mansur, he says, Hafidhullah, that fasting Ramadan is obligatory if one of two things happen. ru'ya to hilal Ramadan, that the person sees the month of Ramadan, okay, then the people have to fast, and this is by ijma'. And also in Bukhari and Muslim, from the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Sumu li ru'yatihi wa aftiru li ru'yatihi." Fast when you see the moon, and break the fast, meaning the end of the month, when you see the moon. So once the moon is seen, then it's obligatory upon people to fast. And some of the ulama, as mentioned by Sheikh Sami Suqair in Rawd al-Murbi', his explanation of Rawd, he said that this is even if the moon is seen via telescope, etc. Did that ru'ya, then that sighting counts. The second thing which causes Ramadan fasting to be obligatory is ikmal iddat sha'ban 30 yawman, that to complete sha'ban as a month 30 days, then this will bring about the fasting of Ramadan. The author, he says, fa'in lam yura ma'a sahwin laylat al-thalathin. If the moon is not seen on the 30th night of Sha'ban, right? The 30th night, which the night is before the day. If it's not seen on the 30th night, أصبحوا مفطرين. So if the moon is not seen on a clear night, okay, they go out and they look on the 30th night and they didn't see the moon, then the next day they don't fast. They wake up and they don't fast. أصبحوا مفطرين. وإن حال دونه غيم. However, when they go out on the 30th and they are looking for the moon, but there is a غيم, there is a cloudy night, أو قطر, أو it is a dusty, hazy type of night, then in this situation, فظاهر المذهب يجب صومه. In this situation, the apparent indication from the madhab that it's obligatory to fast this the next day. Okay. So if the night is clear on the 30th night when they're looking for the moon and there's no moon to be seen, then they don't fast the next day. However, if the night was unclear due to clouds or due to dust in the air, thick dust, then in this situation, the madhab says that it's obligatory to fast the next day. So Sheikh Mansur, Hafidhullah, let's see what he says. He said, إِذَا لَمْ يَرَى النَّاسَ الْهِلَى لَيْلَةَ الثَّلَاثِينَ. If the people don't see the hilal, the moon, on the 30th night, فَلَا يَخْلُ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ حَالَتَيْنِ, then this gives us two situations. الْأُولَى أَنْ تَكُونَ سَمَاءَ لَيْلَةُ الثَّلَاثِينَ سَحْوًا, that the 30th night is sahwan, that there's no clouds or anything of that nature, it's a clear night. فَلَا يَهُولُ بَيْنَ رُؤْيَتِهِمْ غَيْمٌ, so clouds don't come in between them and seeing the moon. وَلَا قَطَرٌ, nor does dust in the air block the sighting of the moon. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُصَامَ الثَّلَاثِينَ, so in this situation, the 30th day, they do not fast. وَيَعَدُّ مُتَمِّمًا لِشَعْبَانَ, and it will be considered as the completion of Sha'ban. The 30th day will be considered as the completion of Sha'ban. وَيَجِبُ الْإِفْطَارُ فِيهِ, and it's obligatory to not fast on this day. In fact, many of the ulama of the madhab, they say it's recommended not to fast this day. They don't say it's obligatory. ولا يصام على أنه من رمضان, and it's not fasted as a day of Ramadan. وهذا هو يوم الشك, and he says that this is the day of shak. And we know the hadith narrated by in the books of Sunan by Al-Arba'a, that the hadith of Amar ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu said, "Man sama al-yawm alladhi yashakku fihi an-nas faqad asa Abu al-Qasim." Whoever fasts the day wherein the people are in doubt, then they have disobeyed Abu al-Qasim. So, meaning disobeyed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Sheikh Mansour is saying that this is the day of shak, right? And the illa, the reason is, أَنَّنَا تَبَيَّنَا أَنَّهُ لَمْ يَدْخُلْ رَمَضَانُ بَعْدٍ, that it's become clear that when we looked out on the 30th night and there was nothing blocking the ru'ya, there was nothing blocking the sight of the moon and we couldn't see it, so it became clear and obvious that there is no moon on that night, therefore we shouldn't fast it. طيب, so that was the first situation. The second situation, أَثَانِيَا أَن تَكُونُ سَمَاءُ لَيْلَةَ الثَّلَاثِينَ لَيْسَتْ سَحْوًا, that on the 30th night, the night is not clear. بَلْ يَحُولُ دُونَهَا غَيْمٌ, rather there is a barrier of clouds between us and the sighting of the moon, possible sighting of the moon. أو قطر, or hazy dust, أو نحو ذلك, or something similar to that, maybe fog for example. فَالْحُكُمْ أَنَّهُ يَجِبُ صَوْمُهُ, so the ruling in this situation is that it's obligatory to fast the next day. Okay, so the 30th day of Sha'ban in this situation would be obligatory to be fast. احتياطاً بنية رمضان, as a احتياط. احتياط is out of care, okay? Out of care that it could be Ramadan. So you fast the next day, احتياطاً, with the niyyah of Ramadan. And the evidence that they use for this, from the evidences in Bukhari and Muslim, the hadith of Abu Umar radiallahu anhuma, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, صوموا لرؤيته وأفطروا لرؤيته فإن غم عليكم فقدروا له, that fast when you see the moon, meaning start the month when you see the moon, and break the month when you see the moon. But if you don't see the moon in the beginning of the month, on the 30th, this is what the ulama intend from the hadith. The hadith doesn't necessarily mean what I'm saying. It's what the ulama, the explanation that we're taking, is what they intend from this hadith. So if you don't see the moon on the 30th night, فَإِنْ غَمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ, then make taqdeer of it, make estimation of the moon or of the month. وَمَعْنَا اِقْدِرُوا لَهُ, and the meaning of make estimation is as follows, أَنْ دَيِّقُوا عَلَيْهِ الْإِدَّةِ, is that you restrict the month of Sha'ban to 29. So in the situation with the night on the 30th, okay, on the night of the 30th, you cannot see the moon because there are clouds or something of that nature, which is blocking your ru'ya, which is blocking your sight of the moon, possible sighting of the moon, then in this situation you make taqdeer, you restrict the month of Sha'ban to 29 days. So the 30th day for you will be fasting. أَنَّهُ مَرْوِيٌ أَنْ جَمْعٍ مِنَ الصَّحَابَةِ, sorry, and also from the understanding of taqdeer, of اِقْدِرُوا لَهُ, is they get from the Qur'an, وَمَنْ قُدِرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقُهُ فَلْيُنْفِقْ مِمَّا آتَاهُ اللَّهُ, that whoever, وَمَنْ قُدِرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقُهُ, that whoever's, Allah is saying that whoever has restriction in his rizq, then he gives from that which he is able to give, right? So قُدِرَ in the Quran means to restrict. So they took this meaning of restrict and applied it to the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ said that if you do not see the moon, then make taqdeer, فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ, means to restrict. So what they did, they said that the month of Sha'ban on the 30th, if you don't see on the 30th night, you don't see the moon, then you make restriction of the month by bringing it to 29, and the 30th day for you will be the first day of Ramadan, احتياطاً, out of care. So Sheikh Mansour, he said, أَنَّهُ مَرْوِي أَنْ جَمْعٍ صُحَابَ مِنْهُمْ, so it's related from a group of the Sahaba, رضي الله عنهم, and from them is the one who narrated the hadith that we just mentioned in Bukhari al-Muslim. صوموا لرؤيته وافطروا لرؤيته فإن غم عليكم فافطروا له. So this hadith in Bukhari and Muslim was narrated by Ibn Umar. So from Ibn Umar and other companions, they narrated the following, as mentioned in Al-Kubra of Imam al-Bayhaqi. They mentioned this athar, this statement of the companions, some of the companions. They said, لأن أصوم يوما من شعبان, that I fast a day from شعبان, أحب إلي من أن أفطر يوما من رمضان, is more beloved to me than I do not fast a day from Ramadan. So they're saying, in a situation like this where we have to make taqdeer and we're not 100% sure that it's going to be Ramadan the next day, it's more beloved to me that I fast rather than missing a day of Ramadan. This is what they're saying. وَهَذَا مَعْنُ قَوْلُهُ. And this is the meaning, all that we've mentioned is the meaning of وَإِنْ حَالَ دُونَهُ غَيْمٌ أَوْ قَطْرٌ. Is the meaning of the author's statement where he said that if between you and the sighting, possible sighting of the moon, is clouds or dust or something of that nature, فَذَاهِرُ الْمَذْهَبُ يَجِبُ صَوْمُهُ. Then the apparent ruling of the madhab is that you should fast this day. روايه الثانيه عن احمد. A second narration from Imam Ahmad, انه لا يجب صوم هذا اليوم وانه هو يوم شك. So a second riwayah, second narration from Imam Ahmad and some of the imams of the madhab, they say now this day where you didn't see the moon on the 30th night, the next day you shouldn't fast it, okay, even if there was something between you and the possible sighting of the moon, because this in their estimation is the day of shak, is the day of doubt. And that would go back to the hadith of Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu that we mentioned, من صام اليوم الذي يشك فيه الناس فقد أصر أبا القاسم, that whoever fasts the day when people are in doubt, then he has disobeyed Abu al-Qasim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, and this is the statement of the majority of the ulama and from the Hanbali scholars, اختاره ابن تيمية, ابن تيمية and ابن مفلح. Rather, Ibn Taymiyyah, he said, لا يستحب صومه. Ibn Taymiyyah said, it's not recommended to fast this day, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. The author, he says, وَإِنْ رُيَا نَهَارًا فَهُوَ لَيْلَةِ الْمُقْبِلَةِ. And if the moon is seen during the day, okay, now there is some discussion whether this is before Zawal or after Zawal, but in both situations, the ruling applies, inshallah, and Allah knows best. So if the moon is seen during the day, then it's to be considered the moon of the following night. إِذَا رَأَ النَّاسَ الْهِلَالَ نَهَارًا. Sheikh Mansour says that if the people, they see the moon during the day, فَإِنَّهُ يُعْتَبَرْ لَيْلَةَ الْمُقْبِلَةِ, then it's to be considered for as being the moon of the following night. سَوَاءً كَانَ ذَلِكَ فِي التَّاسِعِ وَالْعِشْرِينَ, whether that is in the 20th, 29th day, أو فِي ثَلَثِينَ, or in the 30th day. سَوَاءً رُؤْيَ فِي ثَلَثِينَ قَبْلَ زَوَالٍ أَوْ بَعْدَهُ, whether that has been seen before Zawal, before midday or after midday. طيب. The author, he says, وَإِذَا رَآهُ أَهْلُ بَلَدٍ لَزِمَ النَّاسِ كُلُّهُمَ الصَّوْمُ. If the people of a land see the moon, then it's obligatory upon all of them to fast. It's obligatory upon all of them to fast. What does this mean? Sheikh Mansour, he said, إِذَا رُؤِيَ الْهِلَالِ فِي بَلَدٍ, if the moon is seen in a place, فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ يَكُونْ رُؤْيَا مُعْتَبَرَ لِغَيْرِهِمْ مِنَ الْبُلْدَانِ, then that رُؤْيَا, then that sighting is going to be one which is considered legally as a sighting for everybody else in every other land. وَحِينَهَا يَلْزِمُ أَهْلُ الْأَرْضِ كُلُّهُمَ الصَّوْمُ عَمِلًا بِتِلْكَ رُؤْيَا. And in this situation, then all of the earth has to act upon the sighting which was first found. Okay, that's what he's saying. So the sighting which was announced in a land and it's been made public, then that ru'ya is for everybody in every land. We have the hadith that we mentioned previously in Bukhari, where the Prophet ﷺ said, "Sumu li ru'yatihi wa aftiru li ru'yatihi." Fast when you all see the moon, and break the fast when you all see the moon. So the wajh al-dalala, the point of evidence from the hadith, is that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned it in plural context, okay, not mufrad. He mentioned it in plural context with the wawul jama'ah, that when you all see the moon, then start to fast, and when you all see the moon, then break the fast. وَقَدْ وَقَعَتَ رُؤْيَا فَيَجِبُ صَوْمُهُ, and verily the moon was seen, so everybody has to fast. لِأَنَّهُ ثَبَتَ كَوْنُهُ مِنْ رَمَضَانَ وَالْخِطَابُ لِجِمِيعَ الْأُمَّةِ, because it's been now it's now made certain that it's Ramadan, and the khitab, the address from the Sharia, from the Sharia, the Quran and the Sunnah, is for the whole of the Ummah in this situation from this hadith. Aqawlu thani, another riwayah in the madhab, another narration in the madhab, أن المعتبر في ذلك هو اختلاف المطالع واتفاقها, that what you have to look at is what is known as الاختلاف المطالع, is that, let's keep reading. فمتى رؤيا في بلد, so whenever the moon is seen in a particular land, فإنه يجب عليهم الصوم, then that land, it's obligatory upon them to fast. ولا من يوافقهم في المطلع والمنزلة الهلال. And whoever else has the same moon sighting, whoever else from their land is possibly able for them to see that moon. Okay, then in this situation, it's obligatory upon them to fast. Whereas those who live in a land so far away that they're unable to see that same moon sighting, then it's not obligatory upon them. And this is what the opinion of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah from the Hanbali scholars, and it's also the opinion of Imam Shafi'i rahimahu ta'ala. So this is known as ikhtilaf al-mutala'. The author, he says, وَيُسَامُ بِرُؤْيَةِ عَدْلٍ. And the fasting is obligatory if one person sees it who is adl. What is adl? يَشْتَرِطُ فِي مَنْ يَرَى الْهِلَالِ. It's made as a condition in the description of the one who sees the moon, al-adala, that the person has adala. Wal-adl huwa man hafadha ala al-wajibat. And adl is the one who is continual and punctual upon the obligatory acts which Islam has made obligatory. وَتَرْكُ الْكَبَائِرِ. And the leaving off of the major sins. وَلَمْ يُصِرْ عَلَى الصَّغَائِرِ. And the person doesn't persist upon the minor sins. وَيَكْفِي فِي هَذَا وَاحِدٌ. So in this situation, one person suffices as being a legitimate sighting of the moon. وَالدَّلِيل in Abi Dawood, the evidence is from Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, where he said, تَرَى النَّاسُ هِلَالٌ. تَرَى النَّاسُ هِلَالٌ. The people went out and they were looking for the moon. فَرَأَيْتُهُ. So I saw it. فَأَخْبَرْتُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So I told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, فَصَامَ فَأَمَرَ النَّاسِ بِسِيَامِهِ. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam fasted and he ordered the people to fast due to my sighting of the moon. طيب. So based upon this, it's accepted if the person is adl, that the person sighting, even though he's one, is sufficient for the month of Ramadan to be legally now considered to have started. Sheikh Sami Suqair, in his explanation of role, he mentions an interesting point. He said that the quality of adala, which Al-Imam Al-Hajawi is mentioning, is something which is very rare today. You know, somebody who is punctual all the time upon the obligatory deeds and stays away from the major sins and doesn't fall into continual acting upon minor sins. And also some ulama, they add that the person has muru'a, that the person has then it's very difficult to find this kind of person. So Sheikh Sami Suqay said that some of the ulama, they said that as long as the person is thiqa, as long as the person is trustworthy in general, okay, and he's trustworthy in his sighting, that he has the strength of eyesight, then this is what suffices. Because it's hard to imagine a Muslim that even though he falls into sins, whether it be major or minor, that he would then come and lie to the authorities about having sighted the moon, knowing that based upon his sighting, millions and millions of people are going to do the act of worship based upon his sighting. So it's unlikely, very unlikely, that a person, even though he may commit sins, would play around in this matter, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. The author, he says, Walau untha, even if it's a woman, meaning that even if it's a woman that cites the month, even if it's one woman that cites the month, and she has the descriptions that we mentioned, then the citing would be valid. The author, he said, low. What do we mean by low at times? I've mentioned this many a time in previous lessons. What does low indicate to us? Question to yourselves. Ahsant, barakallahu fiqh, zakallahu khair. So there's a difference of opinion on this issue, whether in the madhab or a strong difference of opinion outside of the madhab. لا فرق في الرؤية بين الذكر والأنثى. So Sheikh Mansour said there's no difference between the رؤية of the male or the female. فالمرأة كالرجل يقبل قولها في دخول شهر. So a woman is like the man in this situation. Her statement is accepted for the month to have entered. والعلة أنه خبر ديني. And the reason for this is that it's a خبر ديني. That it's a خبر ديني. That is pertaining to the matters of the religion. فَقُبِلَ خَبْرُهَا بِهِ كَالْرِوَايَةِ. So her narration is accepted like it is accepted in ahadith, narrating ahadith. Okay. وَلَا فَرْقْ بَيْنَ الْحُرُّ وَالْعَبْدِ كَذَلِكَ. And there's no difference between the free person or the slave likewise. Whether the free person or the slave, or it's a male or female, sees the moon, as long as they fit the descriptions that we mentioned, then the month is legally now started. The author, he says, فَإِنْ صَامُوا بِشَهَادَةِ وَاحَدٍ ثَلَاثِينَ يَوْمًا فَلَمْ يُرَى الْهِلَالِ. If the people, they fasted the month of Ramadan, 30 fasts, and this fasting was based upon the shahada, was based upon the testimony of one person sighting the moon in the beginning of the month or for the beginning of the month. And now at the end of the month, after having fasted 30, فَلَمْ يُرَى الْهِلَالِ, then the moon has not been sighted, or أَوْ صَامُوا لِأَجْلِ غَيْمٍ لَمْ يُفْطِرُوا, or they fasted that day of shak, according to the second riwayah, that day, the 30th day, where there was on the 30th night something blocking the possible sighting of the moon. In these two situations that we just mentioned, the people, they don't break their fasting. They have to fast the next day. Okay? Sheikh Mansour, he said, أَشَارَ هُنَّ إِلَى مَا يَتَعَلَّقُ بِحُصُولِ الْخَطَى فِي الرُّؤْيَةِ. The author is pointing to that which is pertaining to the mistake which has been gotten in sighting the moon. وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ الْمُؤَلِّفُ لِلْمَسْأَلَةِ سُورَتَيْنِ. And the author has mentioned for this issue two surah, two scenarios. الْأُولَى إِذَا صَامَ النَّاسِ بِشَهَادَةِ وَاحِدٍ. If the people, they fasted the month of Ramadan based upon the sighting of one person, A, ثَبَتَتَ رُؤْيَا لِلْحِلَالِ رَمَضَان بِوَاحِدٍ. وَصَامُوا 30 يَوْمًا, and they fasted 30 days. مَعَ ذَلِكَ لَمْ يَرَوْا الْهِلَالِ. With that being the case, they fasted 30 days, and it was due, it started with one person sighting the moon, and they haven't seen the moon to end the month, they haven't seen the moon of the next month. فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يُفْطِرُونَ. So in this situation, they are not allowed to break their fast. لِأَنَّ الْخُرُوجُ شَهْرُ لَا يُثْبِتْ إِلَّا بِرُؤْيَةِ عَدْلَيْنِ. Because the ruling in the madhab is that the khuruj of the shahr, to come out of the month, it's not acceptable except with the sighting of two people who have adala, two people who have the descriptions of adala. فَلَا يَجُوزْ أَنْ يَسْتَنِدَ إِلَى رُؤْيَةِ وَاحِدٍ. So it's not permissible in the coming out of the month of Ramadan to base this upon the sighting of one person. وَهُوَ الَّذِي شَهِدَ بِرُؤْيَةِ الْهِلَالِ رَمَضَانِ. طيب. وَلِأَنَّهُ لَمْ يُرَى الْهِلَالِ فَهَذَا أَمَارَةٌ عَلَى أَنَ شَاهِدْ بِهِلَالِ رَمَضَانِ قَدْ أَخْطَأَ. And due to the fact that the hilal, the moon of the next month, has not been seen, this is an amara, this is an indication and a sign that the sighting of the beginning of Ramadan was a mistake. Therefore, the people, they have to fast the next day. The second scenario, إِذَا سَامَ النَّاسِ يَوْمَ الثَّلَاثِينَ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ. That if the people, they fasted the 30th day of Sha'ban, مَعَ وَجُودِ الْغَيْمِ وَقَطْرِ, and they fasted this due to the 30th night, there was clouding, etc., blocking the view. ثُمَّ أَكْمَلُوا رَمَضَانَ 30 يَوْمًا. And in this situation, they have fasted Ramadan 30 days. وَمَعَ ذَلِكَ لَمْ يَرَوْا هِلَالَ شَوَالِ. And even so, they didn't see the moon of Shawwal. فَإِنَّهُمْ حِينَهَا لَا يُفْطِرُونَ. So again, in this situation, because they haven't seen the moon of Shawwal, and because they fasted based upon the issue that we described of the 30th night of Sha'ban, then they are not allowed to break their fast. Rather, they have to fast the next day. وَالْعِلَّةُ أَنَّ صِيَامُهُمْ أَوْلُ شَهْرٍ إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِحْتِيَاطٌ لِلْإِبَادَةِ. And the reason, given the technical reason, is that their fasting of the first day of Ramadan in this situation was ihtiyatan. It wasn't based on yaqeen, rather it was based on possibility and care, right? La an bayyinatin wa ru'yatin, not on clarity and not on clear sighting. So in these situations, they have to fast the next day. The author, he says, I think this is our last point for today, وَمَنْ رَأَى وَحْدَهُ هِلَالَ رَمَضَانِ وَرُدَّ قَوْلُهُ أَوْ رَأَى هِلَالَ الشَّوَالِ صَامٍ. And if a person sees the sighting of the moon of Ramadan by himself, and his testimony is rejected, or he sees the sighting of Shawwal and his testimony is rejected, then in both cases, he has to fast. So if he knows that what he saw is the moon of Ramadan, the hilal of Ramadan, excuse me, then he has to fast, even if his testimony is rejected. And in the end of the month, if his testimony is rejected for seeing the moon of Shawwal, then he has to also fast. He has to continue the fasting. وَالْإِلَّا. The reason, أَنَّهُ تَيَقَّنَ أَنَّهُ مِنْ رَمَضَانِ. the person is sure that this sighting that he saw is from Ramadan. فَلَزِمَهُ صَوْمُهُ Therefore it becomes incumbent upon him that he fasts. كَمَا لَوْ حَكَمَ بِهِ الْحَاكِمِ Like, similarly, if the ruler was to give the ruling that you have to fast, the whole community, his individual sighting is the same ruling for him. It has the same validity. مَنْ رَأَى هِلَالْ شَوَالِ And whoever sees the hilal of Shawal وَحْدَهُ Okay? And whoever sees the halal, the month of Shawal, the moon of Shawal by himself. وَالْمَطْلُوبْ شَاهِدَانِ And it's required that there be two witnesses. أَوْ كَانَ اثنين فَإِنَّهُ يَلْزُمُهُ الصَّوْمُ So in this situation, again, if his testimony is rejected for the sighting of Shawal, then he has to fast وَلَا يُفْتَرْ The Prophet ﷺ in the hadith in Tirmidhi said, الفطر يوم تفطرون والأضحى يوم تضحون Okay, and that the fitr, the breaking of the fast, is the day you all break, meaning Eid al-Fitr is the day you all celebrate Eid al-Fitr as a community. You've all agreed that the month has come to an end. And the day that you make Adha, the day of Adha, again, is based upon communal agreement. Another opinion in the madhab, a second opinion of Ibn Aqil, who's from the companions Rahimahullah Ta'ala of Imam Ahmad Rahimahullah Ta'ala, who said that there is no fasting in this situation. In these two situations with the person, in the end situation of Shawwal, where the person has seen the moon of Shawwal, whether it's one person or two people, and their testimony has been rejected for whatever reason, then upon these two people, they shouldn't fast because they know that they saw the moon of Shawwal, right? So for them, they shouldn't fast. Rather, what they should do is they should make iftar, but they should make it secretly. Secretly, why? In order to keep the hurma of Ramadan, in order to keep the sanctity of Ramadan in the eyes of the people, and in order that people won't make accusation of them having a deficiency in their religion. And we'll stop here, inshallah. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anything which was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The shortcomings and mistakes was from myself and shaitan. I ask Allah to make this beneficial for us and heavy in our scale of good deeds. Ameen. If you have any questions, then feel free. Wa jazakum Allah khair. Point to note that starting from this lesson, everything we do in Ramadan is going to be tested heavily in terms of understanding the text thoroughly. So I'm not going to ask you really and truly on too many differences of opinions, whether within the madhab or out. Actually, we don't deal with opinions outside of the madhab. I'm not going to ask you of second opinions in the madhab, but I am going to ask you questions upon the text itself and for you to understand the rulings based upon the text and for you to give me evidences that I have mentioned to you. So please revise diligently for this chapter that we are taking newly. Any questions, feel free.